Today, we're gonna learn about expert system. But before we go any further, let's talk about human experts and expertise first. Expertise can be defined as the extensive, task-specific knowledge acquired from training, reading, and experience. This can be theories about the problem area, meta-knowledge, which is knowledge about knowledge, and rules, among others. Expertise is usually associated with a high degree of intelligence, but not always with the smartest person. Someone with a PhD in computer science might not be able to design a building as good as an architect. Expertise is usually associated with a vast quantity of knowledge, where experts often learn from past successes and mistakes. Human experts behave in a way where they often recognize and formulate problems and proceed to solve the problems quickly and properly. They are also able to explain their solution, restructure knowledge, and determine relevance. Experts are 1 in 100. Having an expert system transfers expertise from an expert to a computer system and then to other humans. According to Professor Edward Feigenbaum of Stanford University, an expert system is a computer system that emulates or acts in or respects with the decision-making capabilities of a human expert. This basically means that an expert system should be able to solve real-world problems that ordinarily require human expertise. It should be able to deal with small, well-defined domains of expertise and explains the reasoning behind the solution. It can also act as a cost-effective consultant if being deployed in a suitable situation. For example, in domains where experts are limited. Or maybe to provide initial expert opinion in remote areas which will take time for human experts to arrive. Or even to enhance the performance of tasks by applying heuristic expert knowledge. This can include systems that diagnose medical illness, adjust capacity between economy class and business class seats, or simply to troubleshoot your PC problems. In the early to mid-1980s, the desire to build expert systems was very high in the US and elsewhere. AI researchers are aggressively recruited by industry, and expert systems were considered by many to be the next big thing. It is a very fashionable area of AI in the period of 1985 to 95. Some of the famous systems include Dendrol, a rule-based system that inferred molecular structure from mass spectral and NMR data. Mycene, a rule-based system to recommend antibiotic therapy. And Prospector, a rule-based system to explore ore and oil. Today, expert systems can be seen in the form of a chatbot, which is more conversational and natural. The components of an expert system include human expert, which is the expert that can solve the problems the system intended to solve. Knowledge engineer, that will transform expert's knowledge in a declarative form that can be used by the expert system. Knowledge base, which contains declarative representation of the expertise, often in if-then rules. Interface engine, which is the code at the core of the system. User interface, which is the code that controls the dialogue between the user and the system. And finally, the user themselves, who wish to get advice which would have been provided by the expert. The knowledge base contains the knowledge necessary for understanding, formulating, and solving problems. There are two types of knowledge. Factual knowledge, the information widely accepted by the knowledge engineers and scholars in the task domain. And heuristic knowledge, which relates to practice and accurate judgment that often comes with experience. The success of any expert systems majorly depend on the quality, completeness, and accuracy of the information stored in the knowledge base. Therefore, it is important for knowledge to be represented correctly. We will discuss on different types of knowledge representation in another video. Till then, thanks for watching!